focus? Can't tell.
Okay, so I want to do a quick review of the G7. I have some notes here, so if I look down here, you guys know why. I had this camera for about a little over a week, and I think I've played around with it enough to kind of give like a small perspective review on this camera. The first thing I want to get to is the price point. For the price point, honestly, if you're looking for a 4K camera, this probably is the best 4K camera that you will get for the money. So if that's kind of like your own main concern, if you want to stay really budget friendly while getting a pretty damn good camera at that, then of course the G7 probably is, or at least should be, one of the considerations that you have going on in your head. The second thing you kind of want to figure out is, what are you going to do if you're a photographer, if you're a vlogger, if you're like a run and gun type of vlogger, or if you're this type of vlogger, or are you a filmmaker, you know, something along those lines? Because this camera, it does take really good stills, but this is more of a video oriented camera, and but it's not like that video oriented to be like a film camera, because there's no in-body stabilization, there's only lens stabilization. So that would be something to consider. If you're doing what I'm doing right now, this camera is beyond perfect. Even if you're doing some run and gun scenarios, this camera is not the best, but it'll work, and I'll explain why later on in the video. The third thing you kind of want to consider is, do you need 4K? If you really absolutely need 4K, again, that kind of goes back to the price point. You get the best bang for your buck, because this is just under $500 and it has 4K quality. So of course, again, this is something that you should probably be considering. I personally, I do need 4K, because most videos I upload, or I record in 4K and then I upload in 1080p. Because it compresses that 4K quality into a smaller density. So overall, you just get a better picture quality rather than if you just upload it in 1080p. Now, the fourth thing, I'm kind of on the edge or on the fence of this. Do you need amazing autofocus? Like, I'm talking about amazing autofocus. If you just answered yes, you can probably stop the video right now and just get either a Sony or a Canon. But if you want really the best, you should probably get Canon, because their autofocus is like ridiculously fast, but they don't have any 4K quality in their cameras. So that's another thing that you guys should probably be considering. The fifth thing I want to talk about is the actual feel of the camera. After all, you are going to be touching it and holding it pretty much the whole time you're using it, so not unless you're using like some sort of gimbal or a tripod or something like that. But overall, the feel of the camera is fantastic. It's really, honestly, it at least goes to my hand perfectly. It's almost as if it's molded to my hand. It is very tiny. I think it's probably one of the smallest mirrorless cameras of its type, not counting the Sony, you know, A line. But of its type, is probably the smallest DSLR looking mirrorless camera. The sixth thing I want to talk about is the actual weight of the camera. This camera does weigh pretty much nothing. I mean, with my entire setup, I have the camera, the battery, obviously, and the microphone, the Rode Video mic, or the Rode Video Micro. And altogether, that weighs just about a pound and a half, maybe a little less. So it's pretty much like nothing, not compared to any of the bigger full-frame cameras that people vlog around with while holding it out at arm's length. I have no idea how they do that, but with this camera, you're way perfect enough to do that. The seventh thing I want to talk about is the actual battery life. The battery life on this camera is pretty much fantastic. I've never had a situation in my about a week of using this camera pretty much all day. not all day, but like playing around with it here and there. Never once did I have to really, you know, stop and charge the battery and then start using it again. The battery life will easily last you your vlogging time. It's pretty good. I don't know the exact like hours of it, because I've never really continued, or I never really recorded like an hour or something of continuous video before on this camera. So I don't know about that, but from other users, they're saying about hour or hour and a half of video And if you're doing 4K video, it'll be about 45 minutes to an hour. So that's something to keep in mind. But for me, the battery life is fantastic. I have the Sony A5000, and the battery life on that is just beyond horrible. So this is still a pretty big upgrade for me. And that would be all, but I did think of one more thing that I wanted to mention, and that would be the actual operating system of the camera, you know, the actual menu system. The menu system of the Lumix cameras is, for me, pretty easy to get through. It's pretty much kind of self-explanatory. I know where everything is. I don't really need to hunt. I don't really need to go on like YouTube to find out where something is. It's a pretty easy menu system. It's easy to get along with. It is touchscreen, and the touchscreen is pretty really responsive. I mean, it's almost like touching your iPhone. I mean, it really is like that responsive. So you don't really need to use that little back dial or the four-way analog stick thing. You don't really need to use that. You can use the touchscreen 24/7 if you would like, without pressing any buttons, except the menu button. But that's pretty much it. But the menu is pretty easy to get through. It's a lot easier than the Sony cameras. That's like 100% sure. But like, again, this is my first actual mirrorless camera that I've owned personally. I've used others, but this is the one I owned, and I can't have nothing bad to say about the menu system whatsoever. So hopefully that kind of gets you guys some tips and information on regards to this camera. Honestly, for the money, you really cannot beat it. Literally, you just cannot beat it for the money. There's just really nothing wrong with it, except autofocus. But I did make a video. I'll put it somewhere on the screen. I'll put the video so you guys can see a trick into getting your autofocus to work faster and more sensitive on this camera. Because the GH5 setting of changing the shutter degrees, there's no option on the G7 to do that, but I found a little workaround. So again, look into that. But overall, I do like the camera. I am upgrading, though. I'm upgrading to the GH5 soon, so look out for that. That'll definitely be up. And I have a new lens coming in. It's going to be a 15mm 1.7. So pretty damn good in low light. And we're going to see how that works on this camera as well as the GH5. So stay tuned. If you're new to this channel, subscribe. And give me a thumbs up, because I'm broke and I really need the money. No, I'm kidding though. No, I'm serious.